Very interesting table about Hanukkah. We should have this week. So what you see in this table, many verses. So let us try to follow each verse. The first thing is the center you have here, into darkness. In Hebrew is Kes Lachoshech. Into darkness, and it comes with Hanukkah. You can see it in red, Hanukkah. And this fits with the first verse in Genesis, the earth being unformed and void, with darkness over the surface on the deep, and the wind from God sweeping over the water. Then the continuation is God said, let there be light, and there was light. So this is what you see here. It is very interesting that the expression lights, the first time in the Torah, is in the 25th verse, which is like the date of Hanukkah, 25th. So you see this also here. Now there is a Midrash which says the following, that the darkness is the Greeks who darkened Israel's eyes with their decrees, Bereshit Rabbah 2:4. In fact, the Midrash refers to each expression, says it. Tov is Babylonians, Bo is Persia, Iran today, then Greeks, and then Edom, and then the wind which is hovering over the water represents the Messiah will come in the merit of water, which is repentance, prayers, when a man pours his heart. So what you have more in this table? The first thing you have in the center is into darkness, that's the Choshech Hanukkah. And what is interesting that you have here the hero of Hanukkah, Matityahu. Matityahu comes here in quite small skip, Matityahu. Then also the location is very interesting because the location is about the menorah, the candlestick in the tabernacle, which is to do also with Hanukkah. You see here, about Moses, he placed the lampstand in the tent of meeting opposite the table. Now rabbis tell us that the, really the candle of Hanukkah is a continuation of the lamp in the tabernacle. Now rabbis tell us that when Aaron claimed why he didn't participate in the inauguration of the altar, so God told him, don't worry, you will have something more important. This is lighting the candles in the temple. So definitely the question is also, lightning is limited in time. So God, the answer is famous, that God said, no, it is Hanukkah. Hanukkah, when you light the candles, the lamp is exactly continuation of the lamp in the temple. And this is really what is written, that the light of Hanukkah, like the light in the temple, is a hidden light. Now what you have more here? You have your son of Jesse. You have your son of Jesse. And you have here, also very interesting, Elijah, because Elijah will come. You have Messiah here, every 8 letters, like the Hanukkah 8 letters. And again, son of Jesse, as we mentioned, but is also mentioned here the enemies of Israel, those who are causing the darkness, because the Choshech, according to Kabbalah, Choshech is abbreviation of 3 nations, Chamor, darkness, which is Ishmael, and Shor, Edom, and Kelev is Amalekite, really. So Choshech, this is darkness, the source of troubles. Which today we have Iran. You have Iran coming here, yeah, clearly. One of the main enemies of Israel. We have the Amalekite coming letter after letter. And the heavenly minister of the Psalm is known to be Samael. He is the heavenly minister of the Amalekite. You have here the ear, Tavshin Pei Bet. Interesting, you have 5782, not 81, very likely that the end of darkness, yeah, will be in this year. It's also the Shemitah, the seventh year. So all together, we are looking at the table, very interesting table, and telling us the conditions, apparently, that we should really have Messiah and happiness and joy, which depends on keeping the mitzvot. So this is what you have here. You have here the main commandments. On the sixth day, work may be done, but on the seventh day, there shall be a Sabbath of complete rest, a sacred occasion. So then the Sabbath is the basis of everything. Now, you have here also, by the way, as I said, you're down also, you have son of Jesse, Ben Ishai. So all together, looking into this table, which fits beautifully with the Medrash, the darkness is Greeks. So very, very significant table.